lifetime achievement award. The gentleman we're going to present it to tonight has been in the business 54 years. He began his professional auctioneer career in 1958, and he was caught up in the auction fever at the age of 5 years old as a young boy attending auctions with his father. In grade school, he began to auction off balls, pens, and pencils for his teachers on Friday afternoon or whatever they could had picked up in the hallways, and in the classrooms, he would auction them off. In 1957, he won the FFA Tobacco Auctioneering Contest. In 58, while working as a pool boy for the American Tobacco Company in Mullen, South Carolina, the auctioneer became ill, and he stepped in and finished the sale for him in selling of the tobacco. And this was the first time he received a check, and his paycheck was $63. So you know how far that goes back, and with some of the commissions today, and him getting $63. In addition to continuing selling tobacco from 1959 into 1970, he worked for the late Wayne Kessler, Kessler and Coward Auction Company in Campbellsville, Kentucky. And I know when I said that, you all know who it is, and it's Rufus Hansford, and he is very ill tonight and could not make it, and his children are very concerned about him. So I'm going to ask John Kessler to come up and present the award.
Take this award back to Rufus. I know he'll be tickled to death to receive it, because Rufus and I have been competitors, but we've also been friends. We've rode a bunch of miles together up and down roads. So on behalf of Rufus, I know he extends his appreciation for this award, and you remember him. He would be here if health would allow it.
Well, I'd like to say, too, he won this award and top 10 auctioneer award before we knew he was ill. I mean, it's neither one of these were gimmies. I mean, he really deserved them. He's an outstanding auctioneer, and we all pray for him to get well as soon as possible. I have a special presentation to make, and then we'll